Let's make this grungy distort text effect in DaVinci Resolve. First of all, add fusion composition to the timeline. It is currently empty, and we need to fill it in. To do this, go to the Fusion tab. Hit Shift plus Space to open the Tools menu and seek for the Background node, add it to the grid. Also, you can add it from the Tools menu bar. Connect Background to Media Out node. Now we have an underlay background. Now let's add the Text plus node, using the menu or drag and drop it from the toolbar. Type the text you want and make style changes before all future editing. Now add the fast noise node. We will use it like a map for our text distortion. Drop it to the viewer window to see the noise texture. We need to make some changes. Set the scale to a higher number, like 350. Set the contrast to maximum and add details. Also, go to the color tab and make a transparent color black by setting the alpha slider to 1.0. Now add the Displace node. Connect text 1 to the background input of the Displace node, yellow 1, and fast noise to the foreground input, green 1. Drop Displace node to viewer, and now we can see a nice distortion text effect. Let's make some changes to make this effect look more interesting. Edit refraction strength to control effect power. Also, we can change the type of the displacement from radius to XY for a different result. We can make a mask to distort text with regions. Select fast noise and add a circle shape mask from toolbar. Edit the mask as you like to isolate our distorted effect and move and resize the shape. Make a soft edge of the mask to make the distorted transition soft and clean. Place the mask as you like. Duplicate the mask shape and add another area of displacement. Move it to another area. The main distortion effect is ready. Let's add more grunge style to this text. Copy the fast noise and displace nodes and connect them between text and the first displace nodes. Make a refraction about 0.06. It will add a little rough edges to the text. Try different settings for a unique result. Connect your node tree between background and media out. I will make some changes to make it look more like a reference video. Change the text color, background fill color. Do you want to elevate your video editing game? Find all you need on Easy Edit Stock. Templates, text effects, presets. Discover a world of versatile assets for your next video. Now add another background node with an ellipse mask to the background before our text tree. Make soft edges to the shape. Now add the grain node before media out to add animated noise. Adjust grain power and grain size to make a grainy look. Next, I'll add an animated texture overlay using the loader node. Once added, it will ask you to select an image or sequence. Here I have a texture sequence and I will select its first frame. Connect the loader with our texture after the grain node. Add transform after loader to fit it to the comp size. And change apply mode on the merge node. I'll select multiply. I like how it looks. And last, I will add a transform node to make a camera shake effect. Place it before media out, go to inspector, and right-click in the text field and select shake. Default settings are too extreme, so go to the modifiers tab and set the smoothness seed to 0.2. Set the minimum value to 0.498 and the maximum to 0.502, so the movement will be fast and short. Also, increase the size to crop the image a little bit. You can animate noise texture to make the title scene more dynamic. To do this, I'll add expression to the scene controls. Right-click scene and choose expression. Now type time asterisk 0.1. It will animate this parameter. Our Grungy Distort text effect is ready.
If you like the result, make sure to hit the like button and follow our channel for more tutorials. See you in next video.